In this video, I'll find out if adding a really cool graphics card to your setup can improve playback and scrubbing and save you time when rendering videos in Adobe Premiere Pro. Let's explore the difference using a graphics card, namely the EVGA GeForce GTX 1080 Ti, makes in Adobe Premiere Pro. First of all, I'm using the CPU only, and as you can see, the CPU handles things pretty well, but as you're scrubbing through, it'll soon spin up to around 50% or so usage. So that's CPU only. I'm also going to render out this 1 minute video, but first of all, let's go into File and let's go to Project Settings, General, and then under the Video Rendering and Playback, we're going to change Mercury Playback Engine Software Only to Mercury Playback Engine GPU Acceleration Brackets CUDA, which enables my graphics card, my lovely graphics card. Now we'll see what kind of a difference it makes, particularly looking at GPU usage as we scrub through. So scrubbing through, giving it a second to catch up there, and you'll see here comes the video again, pretty smooth once it gets into the flow of things, but really not using much of the GPU at all, maybe 3 or 4% max. Most of the playback and scrubbing is on the CPU. Let's try playing back. So if I hit the space bar to play, here we go. This has got a little bit of coloration, and as you can see, 4% utilization on the GPU, 15% on the CPU, sometimes as far as 20 or 30% when a transition is happening between video clips like that. So all in all, not much GPU utilization in playback and scrubbing, but what about rendering out? Now, one thing I must say is very important, and you should do this before trying to use any of the GPU effects inside Premiere Pro or After Effects, make sure you get the latest NVIDIA drivers installed on your system. Super important so that you can make sure that this is going to work properly. Now I'm going to go to File and I'm going to export the media. This is a 1 minute video with some coloration going on, some dissolves as well. And I'm going to render it out as YouTube 2160p 4K. So let's see on my timer exactly how long it's going to take to export this using my GPU first of all. There we go, a 4K video with some color and cross dissolves included, rendered out at 1 minute and 22 seconds using the GPU. As you could probably see, the CPU was sometimes maxing out at 100%, GPU still not really breaking a sweat, going up to around 15% max. Now I'm going to go into File and into my project settings, and I'm going to switch off the Mercury Playback Engine GPU acceleration, switch to software only, which will mean only my CPU is getting utilized. And again, I'll go to File, Export, the Media, and I want a YouTube 2160p 4K Ultra HD preset in use here. Exactly the same. Let's see if it'll take longer than 1 minute and 22 seconds. Starting now. So there you go. As you can see in my example, around a 13% time saving using GPU acceleration versus just the CPU only. And that was just a video with a bit of color on and a few cross dissolves. But if you're doing a lot more graphical intensive stuff inside Premiere Pro, plus you're making longer videos, that can translate into a significant time saving for you using a graphics card like the EVGA GeForce GTX 1080 Ti.